Hey guys, it's Nate, aka The Foot Accountant. Welcome back to the channel. Today I have a sweet video for you guys talking about the best apps and websites that you can use to help you with your FIFA 20 Ultimate Team journey, with your goals, and with succeeding inside of FIFA this year. Basically, these apps and websites are huge supplementary products to FIFA Ultimate Team to help you see prices on the market, to help get notifications when players score goals, we'll talk about that, and to follow along with Team of the Week predictions, live football games, and notice some of that stuff. There are plenty of websites out there that you can use to help you with FIFA Ultimate Team, but these three that I have picked out today are my favorites, and I think that they can help you guys out a lot in some pretty specific ways. So I wanna look at those websites today and kind of talk about them and how they can help you achieve your goals in FIFA 20 Ultimate Team. So if you enjoy this video, make sure you smash a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel if you are new. Let's get in to the websites right here. Obviously, you know the first one I'm gonna talk about. This is my favorite website and also has an app on FIFA Ultimate Team to go up with FIFA Ultimate Team. This is FUTBIN.com. Now, I'm sure plenty of you guys already know about FUTBIN, and I mean, FUTBIN has a lot of competition in terms of other websites, including FootWiz and FootHead, in terms of looking up players, being able to build squad builders, and all kinds of stuff. But I think FUTBIN takes the cake from all those three websites. This one is the best. FUTBIN has access to players right when they get added into the game. Like this Pookie card was announced yesterday when Pookie won Player of the Month, and boom, all of a sudden they have this card in there, into their FUTBIN database with a sweet image behind it, cool graphics, and the in-game stats already in there. So they have a lot of access to these cards. But the coolest thing about FUTBIN is being able to follow these price trends and price graphs. We'll go to a FIFA 19 player just so we can talk about this with you guys. I know a lot of people know about FUTBIN, so I won't spend too much time talking about this one, but I want to take you through a few things on FUTBIN that you might not know about as well. So here's the Messi team of the year. As you can see, the graphs are kind of the main thing for FUTBIN. They've always been known as basically one of the biggest website for keeping track of player prices, looking at graphs for prices, and being able to see when players are high, when they're low, and just being able to see the prices of players. So I think that's one thing that's very important that I wanted to show you on this website. You guys probably already know that, but some things that you guys might not know, and this is why I think FUTBIN is like the best in terms of when it comes to foot websites with the database and everything. Look at all this other stuff that they have up here. You can look at players. You can look at this statistic called the player game performance. This represents how many games and how well cards are doing in the game based on how many goals are scored. Like if we go back to this Messi card, all these statistics up here, FUTBIN gathers from the cards that are listed on the transfer market in the game, the total number of games, goals per game, assists, and they calculate all these things out for you so that you can see which players inside of the game are performing the best. And this is very important for trading with Team of the Week cards and with gold cards very on in the game, because you can see which cards are being used the most and which ones are technically the best in game. You can kind of sort by goals per game and look at some stuff like that. But there are so many features on FUTBIN that we could take you guys through today. I mean, basically, if you want to explore this a little bit more, a lot of people just use the graphs. A lot of people just use like the player search feature and the graphs on this website, but there are so many other things. There's SBCs, challenges listed, community SBC solutions, cheapest players by rating, and SBC rating combination, which are awesome. I love this page right here. You can look at the cheapest players by each rating and sort them, even if you want to look at informs. There's a lot of great stuff in there. You can build squads. You can do a foot draft simulator, generation squads, a swap deals tracker, a draft simulator. There's forums. And one other thing that I want to mention, this is actually one of my favorite parts about FUTBIN, the player of the month contenders. Now you have Premier League, you have Bundesliga, and you have MLS that we get player of the month cards for. So you can get on this website and without even having to make a graph of your own, you can look and see who are some of the top contenders for player of the month. Obviously, September just started. You see some of these guys on here from today's games when I'm recording this video on Saturday. But this is really awesome that what they do. And then you have another market tab over here with some indexes, which are very good to look at during the year. then some more new tools and premium, actually. Premium FUTBIN, premium gets you no ads. I do believe that there is a small cost involved with that. It's a small cost, but it is a way you can support FUTBIN if you do enjoy what they do. But FUTBIN is definitely one of the best websites when it comes to searching players, figuring out player prices, making squads, and just general FIFA news all about players. This is your place to go in terms of a supplementary site for FIFA Ultimate Team. The next thing I'm going to look at, both of these next two things, these websites, and I think they both have mobile apps as well, as FUTBIN does. FUTBIN has the website, which is most popular, but they have a great mobile app as well. I would highly recommend downloading that onto your cellular device. The next thing I'm going to look at, though, is these next two are related to actually IRL games. So, like, real-life games. You know, Premier League games, UCL, Bundesliga, other competitions. This is where these come in. The first one that we're going to look at is whoscored.com. Now, this is a perfect time to look at this because there were games today all across the world, all across leagues. This is a perfect place if you want to look at statistics for games that happened recently for a possible upcoming team of the week. So let's go look at Liverpool game versus Newcastle earlier this morning. Mane, I think, had two goals, if this would load. If we could load this page, please, whoscored.com. I'm advertising your website right now, and you're not loading the page for me. This is great. But basically what this does is it's very in-depth statistics for Premier League games, for basically any type of game, any football game. You can get on here and look at statistics. There's match reports, the match center, which is what I was trying to load. But yes, you can see top performers, and it gives them a rating. That's why I wanted to load the match center. If I could get a picture of this, it's like a timeline. It looks like a pitch, and you have... Let me just click on another one, or maybe it's going to load. I don't know what's going on here. Let's see if I can get this to load, because I really... There it is. Boom. This is the match center. Now, this is huge for Team of the Week predictions, because it shows you the position that the player was in. It shows you the formation. Now, this is the end of the game formation, so you might have to look back at the lineups to the beginning of the game to see where EA could put that card if it does get a Team of the Week. But you can see here it gives a player rating, goals, assists, and some other statistics in here as well. This is great for Team of the Week predictions and looking at what cards could get into the Team of the Week from the next week. So obviously Mane with an 8.5 rating and two goals has a great chance of getting into the Team of the Week next week. And this would be a very easy place to see. He was playing striker in this game, so this would be a very it's a very good tool to basically keep track of real life performances and how they could impact FIFA's Team of the Week. And I love using this website over others, but just because of how in depth it is with the match center. It gives you a rating. It goes very in detail with statistics. Tottenham was another one today. They won 4-0 over Crystal Palace. Heung-min Son had two goals. So I do believe that he could get into the next Team of the Week. But if we could get this to load as well, there it is. You can see Heung-min Son with a 9.4 match rating. I know for a fact that Spurs did not start the game in a 4-2-2. They started the game in a 4-2-3-1. So Heung-min Son was playing center attacking mid or center forward. But again, 9.4 rating, two goals. You can see definitely if there's going to be a Team of the Week from this game, it's going to be Son. And I think that he's basically guaranteed to get that Team of the Week card. Again, this is website is very useful for looking at real-time stats and looking at stuff that could be projected for an upcoming Team of the Week. Now, the next website that I'm going to look at is, again, it's similar to whoscored.com because it is live stats and it is live, games that are happening in real life. But the reason why I want to look at this website with you, it is SofaScore, and I love their mobile app. Their mobile app is fantastic. The reason I wanted to mention this to you guys is because of their notifications. Now, I have notifications on for a very select number of players inside SofaScore.com, and that is for ones to watch and live upgrade players. This is the perfect app to use because these notifications, when somebody scores a real-life goal, which is what you're worried about with ones to watch, if you have invested in some ones to watch players because you think that they're going to score or perform well in the game and possibly get an inform, and you buy that card before the game, you're going to want to turn this you want to download this app and turn these notifications on, because you will get notifications when that player performs well. You can set up the notifications personally to get like match ratings at the end of the game, notifications for goals and assists. So I would definitely set up some notifications for SofaScore, because let's say today, for the Chelsea and Wolverhampton game, for example, you had Tammy Abraham, who scored a hat trick. Let's say that he was a once to watch card. Just putting it out there. I don't think he will. He's not going to be. He's from the academy. But let's just say Tammy Abraham got a once to watch card. We'll just say that he has a once to watch card. He scores a goal here at the beginning. That would be very important information for you to know if you had that once to watch card. That you could maybe sell that card into the hype if you don't think he's going to score another goal, or you could go and buy that card as fast as you can because you know he's going to be rising in price as other people see that he is scoring goals and maybe gets a possibility for a team of the week. That's how the once to watch cards fluctuate, but getting the notifications from this SofaScore app it's very key, because these notifications are so fast, and it gives you time to, if you're on your phone, you can actually get the notification from the app, speed on the companion app really fast, and go buy a couple of those cards or sell a couple of those cards if you need to. So this is very useful for once to watch, road to the final cards, and headliners. Basically any card that gets live upgraded via an IRL in-game happening. So let's say somebody scores or an assist or whatever. So the live items inside a FIFA Ultimate Team, this website SofaScore is perfect for those different situations. So those are the websites that I wanted to look at with you guys today. Again, SofaScore, I use the app. Who Scored? I think they have an app, but I use the website version, the browser, the most. And then FUTBIN, I use the web app, or I use the app on the web, and I use the app on the phone, which I would highly recommend both of you guys, or all of you guys, getting both of those. So if you enjoyed this video and you think it's going to help you out for FIFA 20 Ultimate Team with these three websites, make sure you leave a thumbs up on the video, comment down below if you have any questions, and of course subscribe to the channel if you are new. It's been Nate, the Foot Accountant. Catch you guys later. Peace out.